Should you consider buying a GTX 1070 Ti? Personally, I don't see the big deal about it. I did want to get a 1070 Ti when it first was announced, but now that I'm seeing some benchmark results, especially for the Vega 6056, the Vega 6056 is basically the main competition for this card. And the Vega 6056, the one benefit of that card is that you can install basically the BIOS of the Vega 64 onto it, and basically it's the same card in the end. There's some minor differences here and there that could be the result of just, there are minor indications of like the Vega 64 being better, but at the same time they're within the boundaries of error. So when you get a Vega 56, you're pretty much getting a Vega 64 if you have the know-how of how to overclock it, or even just installing the BIOS of the Vega 64. Yes, there's going to be, I would say there's ultimately going to be some sort of performance difference, but at the same time, it's so minor that it's interesting to note, like, for the MSRP for this card is $400. For $400, you can get GTX 1080 performance, pretty much. Whereas with the 1070 Ti, it is supposedly GTX 1080 performance for $400 as well, but it's more iffy. Yeah, you can overclock it, but until you don't see full-on results, it's looking like the Vega 56 is more akin, if it's more akin to the 64, you're looking kind of in between 1080 and then 1080 Ti or 1080 Ti performance in some games. And in some games, maybe it's a little bit worse than the 1070 or around the 1070's performance. But even then, that's a good deal for a card, especially when you know that's what you're getting. So if you really want to buy or pre-order the 1070 Ti, I would say you should at least wait for what you can for results. I know these cards are going to be harder to get, but once you know the benchmarks for this and what you're getting for that money, maybe it's worth it. But at the same time, if you really trust NVIDIA and you want to get yourself a 1080, but you don't want to spend the $500 for that card, then yeah, maybe the 1070 Ti is for you. But the 1070 Ti may not be for everyone. It's really hard to pinpoint who the market for it is, because you're gonna, if you have a 4K monitor and you want the best gaming card for that, you're going to have to get a GTX 1080 Ti to begin with. If you have a 1440p monitor, the best card for it is still going to be the 1080. The 1080 Ti, I mean, you're going to save maybe $50 to like possibly $100 if you're lucky. And you might get 1080 performance out of it, but you might not. And that's the weirdest thing. Like, you might not. So if you're not going to get 1080 performance for that, you're better off probably getting the 1080 as it is, and if you're not gonna, and if you're just gonna use this for 1440p, then you might just want to look at the original 1070, or like I said, even the Vega 56 would be a pretty good idea to get. The big problem with the 1070 Ti is that the Vega 56 is more capable, especially in overclocking and with the BIOS up like switch that you can do to it. It's more capable in some sense than just the 1080. It's like something in between. Like, it's hard to explain. Like, it's a market of its own, and that's why it's kind of hard to suggest people. However, for the average person who doesn't want to deal with all these BIOS things and stuff, and like they're worried about what they can possibly do to their computer, to those people, then yeah, I can see the benefit of owning the 1070 Ti, especially since it's a $400 card. But at the same time, we're talking about at this current time when these cards might not be around for that much more time. So would I even recommend this card to start off? Not really. Like, that's my main issue. If you already have a graphics card that can play at least most games, upgrading now is kind of a really bad idea. Even still, even with this card coming out, it's still a bad idea. And the reason it's still a bad idea is because GPUs are just way overpriced at the moment. You're not going to get any benefit from going out there and buying a GPU, especially if you can play all games or at least most games with decent settings. Then you're not going to get any benefit unless you're going to get a 1080 Ti and you're willing to know that within maybe 6 months your 1080 Ti is basically going to lose half its value. Then yeah, maybe it's worth if you go out there and buying this card, but it's really hard to recommend it for people. At least with the Vegas 56, if you're gonna use it for mining and stuff, it's meh. Like, it's not the best card either, but at the same time, based on the price, it's not the best card and everything. But again, for mining and stuff, if you're really into mining, that's a different recommendation altogether. You're really still looking for Polaris and all these other cards that existed beforehand. You're not looking for the newer cards. And the mining, if you're trying to get into mining now, you're kind of late anyways. So I don't know who wants to buy these cards for mining anymore. So personally, you guys should go out and try to get what you can get your hands on. But I don't recommend you get your hands on these newer cards alone, since we're looking a few months away from Volta. And Volta might blow these cards way out of the water. Like, you really should consider what you're doing at the moment if you really need it. Like, only buy now if you really, really, really need it. And I really don't know who really, really needs a graphics card, especially a newer one. Like, when you can go out and buy, say, like, the 9 series, even going to the 7 series with the 7, I think it was a 750 Ti or a 780 Ti. I can't remember what was that high-end card for that. I keep saying Ti, but I meant high. I know it's been hard for me to choose, to switch between those two. But the 780 Ti, if it is the 780 Ti, it's still a worth it card, but it's kind of expensive for $130 and stuff. But you can probably still resell it for that price once Volta comes out. Not really going to get that much. Maybe you'll get half, but at least you're only losing $60. And you might have it for $60 price for 6 months. Isn't that bad overall? Like, compared to losing $400 of value if you buy the 1080 Ti or something. I don't think it's going to be that much, but what I mean is it's a much bigger investment. You really should consider how you're spending it, because you're not going to be using this card, I don't think, for that long. If the Volta turns out to be truly twice the power of the 10 series, then you're pretty much looking like last generation. Like, if you bought a 980 Ti, your 1070 is pretty much where that same amount of power is. And that was the 1070 was $400, where the 980 Ti was like 980 Ti was, I think, it was around 800 or something. It was way more expensive. You basically like you're basically losing half the value of the card, and you're getting something that's in mid-range for next year. If you really need to buy a card now, again, like I said, 1070 is the best choice, I guess, for most people. 1080, like, if you can afford it, go with the 1080. But the 1080 Ti is kind of hard to recommend. The thing is, it's hard to recommend any GPU at the moment. And going into the future, you're better off just waiting for whatever Volta has and going with either whatever they're gonna call it, 1170 or 11 or 2070. I would prefer the 20 series name, to be honest, because it's easier to say and it looks like double the performance of the last card. So 2070 is probably what I'm guessing it's going to be. That card might be way more worth it. It'll probably be able to do 4K. It'll probably be 1080 Ti performance at the least. And so I'm guessing around those ranges. So you're asking like $400 for 1080 Ti performance in 6 months. I'll wait for that. Definitely wait for that. But again, up to you guys. Whatever you choose to do, I'm just trying to help you out with trying to choose what you need or figure out what you want to do. If this didn't help you at all, again, comments, I can help you. Didn't even need to comment, just send me an email, like, somehow. I think you can send private messages through here. So that's all for this video. I hope you guys have a good day. I'm signing out. Bye bye.